Hello everyone, apologies for the lack of YouTube videos recently. I've been just focusing on other things in my life, and if you have ever tried to pursue a YouTube channel yourself, you would know that it takes a lot of work with filming and editing to make good videos, and I haven't wanted to half-ass it. So that being said though, I have been posting almost daily over on Instagram, so if you wanted to see what I'm up to in real time, then definitely check that out. First link in the description below. It's a lot easier to post quickly because you just whip out your phone and post a story or grab a clip for a reel or something like that. And I'm trying to move towards more on my YouTube channel, a more raw style where it's more conversational. Like podcasts are so popular now and I really enjoy that format. And so I'm trying not to script my videos so much so it doesn't seem so forced and it's just more natural. More like a conversation between the two of us. So I will post some recent training clips that I've posted on my Instagram, just so up to speed, and hope you enjoy them. So I'll play that for you now.
Better.
Way too much.
I hope you enjoyed those clips. I've been really loving training recently and I've been learning a lot about how to have good tendon integrity, which has meant I can train really hard and jump a lot without having any pain. And when you're not in pain, you can have fun and push yourself and it's a lot more enjoyable. So as some of you know, I have been completing my third and final year of study at the Australian Film, Television and Radio School, aka AFTRS. And I'm happy to say I have officially finished all my classes now for that entire course. I'm fully done, not graduated yet because our graduation projects, like our major films that we have to make, they've been pushed into next year because of COVID. So I'm actually glad about that because now we don't have to deal with the 1.5 meter distancing rule and problems with actors not being able to handle the same props and touch each other and things like that. So it's actually a lot better, and so I've got all my subjects out of the way, and now next year in February we can film our grad project, which is Urban Murrie's, which I'm really looking forward to shooting. We've got an amazing team behind it and I'm the director of that. It's a coming of age story from an Indigenous perspective. I'll link the Instagram in the second link in the description below if you want to check out more about that project. Because that's been really, really exciting. My electives for third year were directing, screenwriting and cinematography. All were so good. I've made so many good connections with the teachers and a lot of friends that I've made from AFTRS that I'll definitely have for a lifetime. So I wanted to share with you in this video one of my assessments that I made for my cinematography elective, which was really, really fun. That's the last one I just completed recently. And for this assessment, we were getting marked on the quality of the images that we were able to produce. So we were having to color grade this footage and we're getting assessed on composition, etc. So for my idea, we were filming in the Sydney Cricket Ground. So there was a lot of old buildings in the Sydney Cricket Ground that reminded me of the 1950s. And I've watched the Queen's Gambit recently, which has got me really into chess. I love the game of chess, it's my favorite game. And it reminded me of that for some reason. So I thought, what's a simple concept that I can film within a 4-hour time period that we had for this shoot? And I thought a chess game would allow for a lot of dynamic and very cinematic shots. And I had two actors I was working with from ScreenWise. They were great, and I asked them to wear some old clothes that were reminiscent of the 1950s, 1960s kind of vibe. And I had brought my chessboard in, set it up in the middle of this old room, cleared out all the tables and chairs, filled the room up with some haze. I was working with a dolly, so I was standing on the dolly as someone was pulling it, and I'm there with a tripod moving around. I've got some photos and videos that I'll pop up now so you can see what I'm talking about. And the concept that I decided to roll with was this man takes this woman on a date where he's going to teach her how to play chess for the first time, and she ends up beating him. So I thought it was a funny little short that would allow me to get really dynamic shots, get close up into the board, and have a nice shallow depth of field as you're zoning in on one chess piece. So I'll play that video for you now and you can have a watch. I hope you enjoyed that film, Check Date. I decided to call it Check Date because in chess, if you win, it's by checkmate. And I thought it was just a funny play on words that they're going on a chess date together and she checkmates him. So I had a lot of fun making this film. I had a lot of fun with all my electives at my time at AFTRS. I would highly encourage anyone interested in filmmaking in Australia to look at applying at the Australian Film, Television and Radio School if it's something you're interested in studying. I've had an absolutely incredible experience. And my teacher for my cinematography elective was an absolute legend. I'll play a clip of me doing this jump at the front of AFTRS, the first attempt I had at it, and he was walking past and saw me do it, and he was just completely chill about it, didn't report or anything, he was totally fine, so I'll play that little clip for you now.
Yeah! Put way too much into it.
I didn't say that.
I hope that clip gave you a bit of an idea of the fun I've been having at AFTRS. It's not even scraping the surface of what we've been getting into and how much I've been learning. I've just really enjoyed the whole course. The 3 years has gone so fast. It is crazy. 3 years flies by, so I want to encourage you all to get out there and start doing something with your time that's productive, because the time's going to go whether you do it or not. And so all that's left now is my graduation project, Urban Murrays, next year. and then I'm all graduated and I'm done. I'm out in the big world. So looking forward to making more of these videos where I'm just chatting with the camera. I'm trying to get better at articulating my words in a succinct manner because it's intimidating talking to the camera, even for me that who does acting things and stuff like that. If, when you take time away from doing it, it takes a while to brush back up on the skills. So I hope this was engaging. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I'll see you in the next one. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. Hope you're going well, and see you later.